Welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Mohammad Ubaid and this is another video of Basics of Structural Analysis series. In our previous videos, we have solved some problems on Macaulay's method. In this video, we will continue our discussion by solving this problem in which we have a prop cantilever beam which is having an overhang of 1 meter CD and there is also an internal hinge at B. In this problem, we are going to find out the elastic curve equation slope at internal hinge. There will be two slopes, one at just right of the internal hinge and the other one just left of the internal hinge B. We will find out the deflection at this internal hinge by using Macaulay's method. If you are new to our channel, please subscribe to my channel and share this video so that this video can reach out to more people who want to learn this method from the very basics. Now let us start with the solution of this problem without any further delay. So we have a beam like this. This is our fixed end, okay, and here we have a roller support, and at free hand we have a load of 10 kilonewtons, and there we have internal hinge. This is our B, and we have a UDL of 20 kilonewton per meters. Okay, and this is our A, this is B, and this is C, and the free hand is D. So as usual, first of all we have to find out the reaction at C. We will find out the reaction at A, okay, because this at A we have a fixed end, okay, so we will have a fixed end moment at A also, or you can say moment at A, okay. Now how we are going to find out these reactions? So first of all, we have a internal hinge at B, okay, which means that we can use this equation sigma MB is equal to 0. And by considering this section, or you can say the segment CD, okay, so we know that at internal hinge the moment will be zero, so we can use this condition sigma MB sum of moments at B is equal to zero for this segment CD. Now the distance between A to B is 4 meters, okay, the distance between B to C is 3 meters, and the distance between C to D is 1 meters, okay. So the first moment will be due to this reaction RC, so about B, and let us take the clockwise direction as positive, okay, so RC is acting anti-clockwise, so it will create a negative moment, so it will be 3RC, and the other one will be due to this 10 kN force, so it will be 10 into 4 is equal to 0, okay. Now from here you can solve for RC, and after solving you will get the value of RC as 13.33 kilonewtons. Okay, now we have got the value of RC here, so I want to find out the value of RA and MA. So let us see how I will proceed for this RA and MA. Now what we can do, we know that at B we have an internal hinge, okay, so internal hinge can only transfer, so let me write it here, internal hinge or you can write it like this, internal hinge cannot transfer any moment, okay, so internal hinge cannot transfer any moment which we have used here because sigma MB will be zero. The other thing is that internal hinge will transfer force, okay, you can say shear force. So we can break this beam AB, or you can see the whole beam A to D, into two segments. So let me draw here so that you can understand very clearly. So this will be our first portion A, and this is B, and the other portion you can draw like this. So here we have our roller support at C, here we have our 10 kilonewton point load, or you can say concentrated load, okay, so this is C and this is D, there we have a reaction of 13.33 kilonewtons, okay, so this is now our beam, separated beam, okay. So as we know that at B we have internal hinge, so moment will be zero, but there will be force, okay, shear force, because this moment, this internal hinge can transfer shear forces, okay. If you want to understand in a better way about all these type of support, you can watch my video and you will find the link of that video in the description box. Okay, but right now we know that shear internal hinge can transfer force, shear force. So let us take that the force, or you can say that the force at B is acting like this. So this is our RV. Okay, so because this point will be jointed here, so this there will be also a reaction which is will be in equal amount of RV in this direction as I have drawn here. Okay, so we have a UDL which I have forgot to draw. So this is our UDL, 20 kilonewton per meter. Okay, now this is our conditions. Okay, so let me draw it again because it is hidden. Okay, like this. So we know the value of RC, which is 13.33 kilonewtons. Okay, now we can use the summation of forces in y direction is equal to zero, taking upward direction as positive, and we will use this for our BD portion. For BD segment. Okay, so how many forces do we have? We have RV, which is acting downward, okay, which I have considered, and we have 13.33 kilonewton, which is RC. The other one is of 10 kilonewton, which is our concentrated load, is equal to zero. So from here we will get the value of RV as 3.33 kilonewtons. Now we have got the value of RP. Okay, so this RV is acting downward at here. Okay, but this RV will be acting in the upward direction at this segment AB, okay, at the end of the segment AB at B. Okay, because we know that there should be equilibrium, so these two reactions will be in the opposite direction to each other. Okay, now we know the value of RB, so we can find out the moment about A very easily. Okay, because this is UDL and we know the value of RB. So let me write it here as this is A. So sigma MA is equal to zero, and if I take clockwise as positive, so this we have assumed anti-clockwise, so it will be minus MA. Okay, and due to this UDL we have a positive bending moment, so it will be 20. So this distance is of 4 meters, so it will be 20 into 4 into 4 by 2. The other moment will be due to this RB, so RB will act in the upward direction, okay, at B for this segment AB. Okay, so it will create a negative moment because here we are considering clockwise as positive, so it will be it is our RV is 3.33 into 4. Okay, so this is RV. So RV we have found out, it is 3.33 into 4. Okay, so we have got the equation for MA. Now we can solve for MA. So after solving we will get the value of MA as 146.68 kilonewtons meter. Okay, so we have got the value of moment acting at A. Now one thing which has remained is the value of reaction at RA. Okay, reaction at RA. Now it is very simple to find out the value of reaction at A, because we know the value of reaction at RV and we know the intensity of UDL, so we can use sigma Fy is equal to 0. Okay, so let me write here sigma Fy is equal to 0 for segment, for AB segment. Okay, for AB segment. Okay, so what are the forces? We have RA, which is we have assumed acting upward. The other will be due to this 20 into 4 due to the UDL, and the other one is RB equal to 0. Okay, we don't know the value of RA, so it will be 20 into 80, and we know the value of RB. So the value of RB is 3.33 is equal to 0. So you can solve for RA. Okay, then RA value will be 76.67 kilonewton. Now we have got the value of all the reactions which we need for solving this problem by using Macaulay's method. Okay, now let us see how we will set up the equations for this problem. So we have separated the beam at internal hinge, okay, like this. Let me draw it here again this is our 20 kilonewton per meter UDL. Okay, and here we have our reaction RV, and the value of this reaction RV was 3.33 kilonewtons. Okay, and the other segment which we have separated is like this. Here we have our roller support, and here we have our 10 kilonewton load. So this is our D and this is our B. Sorry, there will be reaction of 3.33 kilonewton. So this is our P, and here we have a reaction of 13.33 kilonewton at C. This is A, and here we have reaction at RA, which is of 76.67 kilonewton, and we have a moment of 146.68 kilonewton meters. Okay, so these are the forces which are acting on our beams. Now how we are going to write the equation for EI d2y over dx square is equal to m. Okay, so m is the bending moment at any section which we are considering. Now we have separated this whole beam, okay, which is this beam, okay, A to D. We have separated this whole beam into two single beams, okay, as you can see here. Now what we can do, we can write two set of equations, one for this segment A, or you can say AB portion of the beam, and the other one for this BD portion of the beam. Then we will use the boundary condition, we will use the continuity equation to couple these equations, and by coupling those equations we will get our final equation for elastic curves. Okay, now let us see how I am going to do the solution of this problem. Okay, so first of all let us write out the equation of EI d2y over dx square for segment AD. Okay, so let me write it here for AB portion. Okay, so the equation will become, let me erase these things. So let me just draw a line so that you can understand very clearly how we can write out the equations. So first of all we will write out the equation for this segment AB. So it will be EI d2 y1 over dx square. Okay, so I have taken dy1 or x1 for just to distinguish between the portion AB and portion BD. Okay, for BD portion we will take y2 and x2. Okay, so we will measure the distance x1 from A, okay, as we usually do from the initial point of the beam. So let us assume that I have taken a section at this point. Okay, so let us name the section as xx. This is our 20 kilonewton per meter UDL. Okay, so this is our section xx, which is at a distance of x1 from A. Now I want to write the bending moment at this section. So the bending moment will be, first of all let us take the bending moment due to this reaction RA. So due to this reaction it will be 76.67 into x1. Okay, so this is, let me write it here. So this is our x1. Okay, so the bending moment due to this reaction will be 76.67 x1 minus, let us take the bending moment due to this moment acting at A. So it will be 146.68 into x1 minus 0 whole power 0. Okay, so I have taken the whole power 0 because this is bending moment and it is acting at a distance. I have taken here 0 first. Let us understand why I have taken 0 at here. So this bending moment is acting at x is equal to 0, that's why I have taken x1 minus 0, and the other thing is this 0 in the power of this bracket. So this 0 will make this whole bracket equal to 1. Okay, so we will left out with this moment only. Okay, so this is the significance of this 0 power. Now the other moment will be due to, let me erase this also, the other moment will be due to this UDL. Okay, so the UDL will create a negative moment also, so it will be 20 into x1 square by 2. Okay, so the final equation will be 76.67 x1 minus 146.68 x1 minus 0 whole power 0 minus 10 x1 square. So this is our equation for EI d2y1 over dx1 square. Now integrate this equation. Okay, now integrate this equation number 1. Okay, let us name this equation number 1 first. Now after integrating we will get the equation for slope. So dy1 by dx1, it will be 76.67 x1 square by 2 minus 146.68 x1 minus 0 to the power 1 minus 10 x1 cube by 3 plus c1. Okay, constant of integration. Now if I integrate this equation again, so let me increase this line. So integrate, first of all let us name this equation as equation number 2. Okay, so integrate equation number 2 with respect to x1. Okay, because we are using x1. Now what I will get, I will get EI y1. Okay, so it will become 76.67 x1 cube by 6 minus 146.68 x1 minus 0 whole to the power 2 by 2 minus 10 x1 to the power 4 divided by 12 plus c1 x1 plus c2. So this is our third equation. Okay, now we have completed our equations for the segment AB. Now let us write the equation for segment BD. Okay, as you can see here in figure B, so the equation will be like this: EI d2y2 over dx2 square is equal to, first of all we will consider a section in this segment, okay, at a distance x2. Because we have discontinuity, so we have to take two sections in the discontinuity in the loading, so we have to take two sections. Okay, first for this segment BC, the other section will be for the segment CD. As we have done in our previous videos, okay, it should be very clear to you how we are going to do this. Okay, so the bending moment at this section, let us name the section as XX. So at this section, due to the reaction, 3.3 will be minus 3.33 x2. Okay, so there is no other loading in the segment BC other than this reaction 3.33. So let us move on to this segment CD now. Okay, now we have moved our section from this segment to, let me erase this 10 kN, to this segment CD. Okay, now we are, our section is in this segment CD and the distance will be x2. So what I will do, I will place a vertical line, okay, to distinguish between the segment BC and segment CD. Now I will put a positive sign because this reaction at C, will be creating a sagging moment in the segment, or you can say at section XX. Okay, so it will be, moment will be 13.33 x2 minus 3. Okay, why 3? Because this distance is 3 meters up to here. Okay, so it will be x2 minus 3. Now this is our equation number 4. Okay, so integrate equation number 4 with respect to x2. So after integrating we will get, sorry, not d2y, dy2 upon dx2 is equal to minus 3.33 x2 square by 2 plus c1. Remember, we write the constant of integration before the first vertical line, and the other term will be 13.33 x2 minus 3 square by 2. Okay, now we will integrate this equation again. Okay, first let us name this equation as equation number, let us say this equation as equation number 5. So integrate equation number 5 with respect to x2. So after integrating we will get EI Y2 is equal to minus 3.33 X2 cube by 6 plus C1 X2 plus, sorry, this constant will not be C1 because we have used C1 here. So this constant will be our, let us name this constant as C3, okay, and here this will be also C3. We will add another constant C4, okay. All these constant will be different, okay. So these are two terms. Now we will place our vertical line, and the integration of this term will be 13.33 x2 minus 3 whole cube by 6. So this is our equation number 6. Now we have got the equation for slope and deflection for both the segments. Now the task is to find out the constant C1, constant C2, constant C3 and the constant C4. We have four constants, so we need four equations to find out the value of these constants. Okay, now let us focus on the geometry of the beam. So let me draw the beam here. So this is our beam, and here we have a roller support. Here, though, let us not draw the loading, okay, because we are only concerned with the geometry of the beam. So at this point we have an internal hinge. Okay, so this length is of 4 meters, this length is of 3 meters, and this is our 1 meter length. Okay, it is A, it is B, C and D. Now this is the geometry of the beam. So what are the boundary conditions which we can use for this beam? So first boundary condition, let me write here and solve simultaneously. So boundary condition, the first boundary condition will be, because for this segment AB we have used x1 and the x1 was measured from A, and for segment BD we have used x2 and the x2 was measured from B. Okay, so at A we have a fixed support, or you can say fixed end. Okay, so at A, let me write here as, at A the value of x1 is 0 and y1 will be 0 because there will be no deflection at A, and dy1 by dx1 will also be 0 because there will be no slope at A. Okay, so first of all let us use these two boundary conditions, then we will see what are the other boundary conditions. Okay, so first we have x1 as x1 is 0 and deflection at y1 is at A is 0. Okay, so which equation we will be using? So we will use equation number 3, okay, because this equation is for the segment AB. Okay, so how many terms do we need to use? Okay, all these terms will be taken in the consideration because there is these terms will be applicable for the whole beam. Okay, now we are considering at A, so x1 is 0. As you can see here, at A x1 will be 0. So in this equation, this term, the first term, the second term, the third term and the fourth term will become 0. So we will left only with C2. Okay, so let me write here from equation number 3, at x1 is 0 and y1 will be 0. So we will left with 0 on the left hand side and all the term will be 0. We will only get C2 on the right hand side. So from here we will get the value of C2 as 0. Okay, now the other boundary condition is this: at x1 is equal to 0, the slope at support is 0. Okay, because we have fixed support, so the slope will be 0. Now which equation will be using? So we will use equation number 2 because this equation is for slope for the segment, for the segment AB. Okay, and how many terms do we need to take? We will use all these terms because this there is no discontinuity in the loading on this segment AB. Okay, as we have in the segment BD. Now we will be using all the terms in this equation number 2 for slope at A. So as x is equal to 0, so at A the x1 is 0. Okay, as I have written here. So as x1 is 0, Now if I put the value of x1 is 0, so this term will be 0, this term will be 0, and this term will also be 0. So we will only get the term c1 on the right hand side, and as c will be 0, so we will get 0 on the left hand side also. Okay, so ultimately we will get, you can isolate here from equation number 2, at x1 is 0, dy1 by dx1 is equal to 0. So we will get 0 on the left hand side of the equal sign, and we will get 0 in all the terms, and we will get only c1. Okay, so from here I can write that c1 will also be 0. Okay. So we have got the value of c1 and c2. Now let us see how we are going to find out the values of other constants. So we will use our third boundary conditions. So where will be our third boundary condition? So you can see that at c we have a roller support. Okay, so we know that at c we have a roller support. Okay, so we have a roller support, which means that at c the deflection will be 0. Okay, I have written y2 because we have used x2 and y2 for the segment bd. Okay, so y2 will be 0, which means that we can write in such a way that at c2 x2 is equal to 3 meters and y2 will be 0. Okay, at c2 x2 is equal to 3 meter and y2 is equal to 0, because we have used x2 as you can see here in the segment, and we are measured this x2 from b. So at c x2 will be 3 and y2 will be 0. Now we have other third boundary condition, so we will be using this equation number 6. Okay, because this equation relates the deflection and the other constants. Okay, so we know that we are at support c. So how many terms do I need to use? So I will just use these three terms. Okay, I will not use this last term, because this last term will be used for the section in the segment cd. Okay, but I am at support c, so I will just use the term which are before this vertical line, which are these three terms. Okay, now I will just put the value of x2 is equal to 3 meter in this term, okay, and I will see what will be our equations. Okay, so let me put these values. So let me write it here from equation number 6, at x2 is equal to 3 meters, y2 will be 0. Okay, so on the left hand side we will get 0, and on the right hand side we will get 3.33 into 3 cube by 6 plus 3 c3 plus c4. Okay, so after solving this equation you will get 3 c3 plus c4 is equal to 14.985. okay, so this will be the equation which you will get. Now let us name this equation as equation number 7. Okay, so we have used three boundary condition. Now we need one more equation, so we can use this internal hinge. Okay, so this at internal hinge the deflection should be equal for this segment AB and for the segment BD. If we measure, or you can say if we find out the deflection using the equation, let me just go here. If we find out the deflection at B by using this equation number third, which is for segment AB, and if I measure the deflection at B by using the equation number sixth, which is for segment BD, the deflection should be equal. Okay, because we have a single deflection, we will have a single deflection at B. Okay, the slope will be different at this internal hinge. There will be two slopes, one will be for the right and one will be for the left. Okay, that's why we can use the equal slope condition for this internal hinge. We have to use the equal deflection condition at this internal hinge B. Okay, now I will use the equal deflection condition. So let me write here, at IH means internal hinge B, y1 should be equal to y2. Okay, so from equation number third and equation number six, okay, I will compare these two values. Okay, so this is our equation number third, and this is our equation number six. Now the problem is, what is the value of x1 and x2? Okay, so we are considering this internal hinge B. So the value of x1 will be 4. As you can see here, the distance of B from A is 4. The value of x2 will be 0. Very simple. Okay, so let me write it here. Putting x1 is equal to 4 meters because the distance of B is 4 meters from A, and the value of x2 will be 0. Okay, and using this y1 is equal to y2. Okay, so we will just put the values in these two equations. Okay, now let us see how what I will get. So I will just put the values here like this. The first value will be 76.67 into 4 cube by 6, 146.68 into 4 square by 2. The other value will be minus 10 into 4 square by 12. And on the y2 equation, we will get 0 plus c4 because x2 is 0. So as you can see here, all the term will be 0. So we will get only y2. Okay. Now, from here, we will get the value of C4 as minus 568.96. Now, we have got the value of C4. So, from equation number 7, we have two things, C3 and C4. We know the value of C4 now. So, we can find out the value of C3 from equation number 7. So, let me write it here. From equation number 7, 3C3 plus C4 is equal to 14.985. Now we know the value of C3, C4, it is 568.96 is equal to 14.985. So from here we will get the value of C3 as 194.648. So this is our value of C3. So we have got the values of all the constants. Now we can write the elastical equations for both the segments, final equations for AB. Let me write it first. Okay, so the equation will be EI dy1 by dx1 is equal to 76.67 x1 square by 2 minus 146.68 x1 minus 0 to the power 1 minus 10 x1 cube by 3. C1 is 0. Okay. And the other equation will be for deflection, it will be 76.67 x1 cube by 3, sorry, x1 cube by, it will be 6, okay, minus 146.68 x1 minus 0 square by 2, and this term will become x1 to the power 4 by 12, c2 will be 0, okay, as we have found out. Now for portion BD, the first equation will be EI dy2 upon dx2 is equal to minus 3.33 x2 square by 2. The value of C3 is 194.648. Okay, the other term will be 13.33 x2 minus 3 square by 2, and the equation for deflection will be minus 3.33 x2 cube by 6. Okay, and the other term will be 194.68 x2 plus c4. Okay, the value of c4 is 568.90. okay, so this is the value of our c3 and this is the value of our c4. Okay, and we will have this last term, 13.33 x2 minus 3 cube by 6. So these are the final equations. Let me write, name this equation as equation number in numericals. So 8, and this is our 9, this is our 10, and this is our equation number 11. Okay, so we have got our final equation. Now the task is to find out the, we have found out the elastic curve, so the task is to find out the slopes at internal hinge B. Okay, so if I draw the deflected shape, so first of all let me draw the shape of the beam. So here we have our internal hinge and this is our pin support. Okay, so The beam will deflect something like this. Okay, so this will be the deflected shape of the beam. Now this is our internal hinge. Okay, so here we will have two slopes. So the first slope will be like this, and the other slope will be something like this. Okay, so this will be our let me write it here, theta b, sorry, this will be our theta b, right? Okay, and this value will be our theta b left. Okay, so as you can see here, the theta b right is measured in anti-clockwise direction, so this value should come positive, and the value for theta b left should come negative because we are measuring this in clockwise direction, okay, according to our sign convention. So let us find out the values first to prove our assumption. Okay, so the value of theta b left, so we can use from equation number, we are in the segment a b c d, so we are in the segment a b because we are finding out this theta b left. So we will use equation number 9. We will put x1 is equal to 4, and then we will find us, we will use equation number 8. Okay, we are finding our slope, not deflection. Okay, equation number 8, and we will put x1 is equal to 4, and we will see what is the value which we will be getting. Okay, so from equation number 8 at x1 is equal to 4 meters. Okay, so dy1 by dx2, or you can write it here theta b left. Okay, because this is theta, so it will be ei, and on the right hand side I will get 76.64 into 4 square by 2 minus 146.68 into 4. The other term will be minus 10 into 4 cube by 3. Okay, so after solving we will get the value of dy1 by dx2 b L, or you can write it as theta b l is equal to minus 186.69 by ei. Okay, so as I have considered here that we will get the value of theta b l as negative, so we have found out the value as negative. Okay, so I have just assumed the deflected shape of the beam. So this deflected shape can go upward like this. Okay, this deflected shape can go like this also, but I have assumed according to the loading. Okay, so as you can see here, you can also assume this. So as you can see here that the loading on this segment AB is much more than the loading on the segment CD. That's why I have assumed the deflected shape like this, which I have drawn here. Okay, which I have drawn here. Now we have found out the theta B left. So we will find out the theta B right. So for theta B right, we will use the equation for segment BD. Okay, we will use equation number 10, and we will put the value of x2 is equal to 2 because x2 is 0 at B. Now let me write it here from equation number 10 at x2 is equal to 0. So I will get theta B right, as because if I put x2 is equal to 0 in this equation number 10, this term will be 0. Okay, and we will not consider this term. Why? Because we are considering the point A, point B, we are considering the point B, so we will not consider this term. Okay, we will not consider this term, we will only consider these two terms. So this first term will be 0 because x2 is 0, we will only get this 194.648. okay, so I can just write it here, I will get 194.648 by ei as the value of theta b right. Now you can see that we have got the value of theta b right, and this is positive, which we have assumed here. Now the last thing is to find out the deflection at b, so this value, okay, this is y b, so this is delta b. So delta b can be found out from this equation number 9, from this equation number 11, the value should come equal. Okay, so at b x2 is 0 and x1 is 4, so I will use this equation number 11 because if I put x2 is 0, so this will be very very simplified, but if I use x1 is equal to 4, so I have to do a lot, I have to do a calculation. Okay, I have to calculate these three terms, so no need to do that, just use s2 is equal to 0 in this equation number 11. Okay, so let me write it here. Deflection at IHB, internal hinge B. Okay, so at x2 is equal to 0 from equation number 11, we will get EI Y2B. You can write like this for understanding. So all this term will be 0, the first term will be 0, the second term will be 0 because we have x2 in this term also. We will only left with this term minus 568.96. Okay, so it will be minus 568.96 divided by EI. So you can write also theta b, delta b is equal to minus 568.96 divided by EI. So this value is negative, which means that again our assumption is correct because negative means downward deflection, okay, and we have assumed a downward deflection at B. So we have solved all the parts of the problem, and this is it for this video. We will meet in our next video. Thanks for watching.